from behind. Lucas took it away. Deladon has it. And the Hens have won the CAA championship for the second consecutive year. They celebrate at center court. 42 in a row. They run the gauntlet twice.
When that buzzer sounded, I was the happiest person in the United States of America. And, you know, we've worked so hard. It's so incredibly hard to go undefeated 2 years back to back. You know, and to have these young ladies, these are my seven seniors. I'm incredibly proud of these seven seniors. And, you know, it's about the student athlete. So I'm going to shut up, but I want to thank one more group, and that's my coaching staff. My coaching staff has worked tirelessly around the clock, and you know, you can't do this two straight years without tremendous people. And you know, they're not yes people. Sometimes they give me a hard time, and you know, we have some give and take. And but I'll tell you what, to a person, my coaching staff, I truly, truly respect them and love them, and so proud of them and so happy for them and their families, all the recruiting, everything that goes into having a program that we have right now. I'm so thankful to have them with me on this journey, and so thankful to be a champion. Now, this team, you know, they've taken Elena's lead and Parker's lead and Kara. You know, those are my – they're just really strong individuals. And the people we had on the floor, Treme, Parker, Elena – they don't panic. This group behind me, they're probably more calm than I am. I mean, I'm going through about 15 sets in my head thinking how can we get certain people the ball in certain situations, and they're very calm, you know, and Elena just kept saying, we need stops, rebound guys. They weren't panicked at all in the huddle, and we've been through other tight games, so I thought they handled the situation very, very well. We executed when we needed to execute, and obviously Treme got to the line, and Elena got to the line on one of her post-ups and knocked down the free throw very calmly. It's nice to have good free throw shooters on your side late in the game, and seniors, as you could tell, who are very confident young ladies. So my seniors are very calm. I don't know about Chelsea. I didn't get to check with her yet, but she was a little nervous. So she's the one that was a little nervous, but she usually is holding down the fort. So, but no, they're very calm, and Kayla was very calm, and you know, as the point guard. And like I said, I mean, all of them, they just have a quiet confidence about the whole group. And, you know, I could say this now, but Lauren Carras has been playing with a really badly bruised hand. And I just want to say, Lauren, way to suck it up, man. I know we didn't make it public, but her hand is bruised, it's swollen, and she just did a tremendous job. And we didn't let that out to anybody, but she was great.
Honestly, being on this team and having seven seniors on this team and having the experience we do, you don't really get that feeling. Yeah, you see the score going, but I feel like we're all confident in each other that we're going to make the plays. We're going to do what we have to do to pull out a game. And we're really trusting in each other, and we believe in each other.
After probably watching me for 4 years, you probably know that I'm not like a crazy emotional player. So, you know, sometimes I feel there's moments in the game to do that, to get my teammates going. And I think when I do it, it probably gets them a little pumped up since I don't do it all the time. But, yeah, I was just raring to go, and you know, we wanted this championship so bad, so I wasn't going to hold back any emotion.
In all honesty, I mean, us seven seniors, we're never going to play another CAA team again after today, and we didn't want to go out with a loss. I mean, especially going into the NCAA tournament with a loss too, I mean, that's just not good team morale. But being able to get a win against the last CAA team you're going to play and really close out the conference 2 years in a row and go undefeated, I mean, that meant a lot to us. And it didn't matter about NCAA tournament or not. We just really wanted to prove to everybody and prove to ourselves that we are the best team in this conference and that we wanted to come out and show it to everybody else.
You know, the funny thing is, too, after I threw the ball, I look and there's Kayla, my teammate of however many years, ever since I was born, I've been playing with her. So she jumps into my arms, and it's awesome, and this has been an incredible ride.
You know, I'll be honest with you. I am going to enjoy this for a good tomorrow. Today and selection show. As soon as that name flashes up, whoever we're playing, then the smile will be off my face. But honestly, as hard as we've worked and as much as we've gone through as a team, Parker's got a partially torn ACL and all the other issues we've had, Elena's illnesses and everything else. Man, I'm going to enjoy this thing until they announce a name that we have to play. I'm going to 48 hours, 50, I don't know. I have to start the clock now. I have to figure it out. I'm going to enjoy every second of every minute of being undefeated for 2 years. I'm going to enjoy it, and I want my kids to enjoy it. Be responsible, please. I want them to enjoy it, and so we're going to enjoy it for at least a couple days, and then we'll get down to business as soon as we know who we are playing. Our fans are incredible. I mean, did you see Blue Hen Nation out there? I mean, everything's a sea of blue. They're all into it. And, you know, they feel like these are their daughters, and they should. That's what college athletics is all about. The fans have a connection with my team. I love that. My team loves that. And we embrace our fans. They're terrific people. We love it when they come up to us. We love it when they're in the hotel and they're, you know, really supporting us. My administration standing in the back there, wonderful people, have been so great to my team. I love Delaware. Couldn't ask to be at a better place, and I think the kids feel the same way. We are on a very big high right now, a winning high, and we're going to enjoy this. I always thought to myself, that might have been the worst miss we had the entire game, because the water was like, they missed me totally. They missed me totally, and then I was like, wow, somebody's got to clean this up, might as well be me. So I just dove into the water pile and did my little snow angel and tried to help up the people here at the Showplace Arena and mop up the floor. And I wish they actually would have hit me, because let me tell you, I was sweating like crazy, so it would have been nice if they actually put it over my head.
It wasn't me.
See, this is what I'm talking about with my seniors. This is what I'm talking about. I'm telling you. I'm telling you, this is what I'm talking about.
Quetta?
Quetta?
I was on.
I love you. Was that you? Did you do it?
We both did it.
I should have known. See, now that's a direct hit. That's what I'm talking about. That's a direct hit. Outside, and they have a big old target. It's not like I'm a small person. They could have hit me. But they missed me, so I just had to help out a little bit. That's what happened with the water.